The World Future Council is a service organization for policymakers. It's a very unique organization. I've been working for many years to support so-called, you know, best practice, what individuals can do, what businessmen can do, and I found that this still wasn't enough. We need to change the policies. We need to identify best laws, regulations, institutions. And that is what the World Future Council does. By working directly with policymakers, i.e. with members of parliament all over the world, we identify a good law and we use criteria developed by the International Law Association, adopted by the world's countries 10 years ago at their conference in Johannesburg. So it's not something we just, you know, pull out of a hat. So we look if these laws are future-proof, if they are fair, if they're equitable, and then we put them on a special website for parliamentarians and their legal advisors, where they can then adapt them to the needs of their country. They can, you know, put together the best combination, the best law suited for their countries. We do publications, we do parliamentary hearings, we've done, you know, films about this. So that is, you know, what we work with. We have a council of, you know, 50 members who decide our policy priorities, which of course also depends on our resources. There are many crises in the world, but we started with climate energy because we saw it as the most overriding threat. So we have worked very hard on getting policies to spread renewable energies, spread all over the world. You know, policies, so-called feed-in tariff policies, wherever there is a grid where people get paid for the renewable energy they produce. We have got those adopted in countries like Great Britain and various US states and in Japan, etc. So this is our, you know, key work, if you want, sort of the carrot. But the stick is, of course, that we say there are policies which threaten future generations, there are crimes against future generations, and we're working to get that concept of crimes against future generations also accepted as a crime by the International Criminal Court. We also have a prize for the best policy, the Future Policy Award, which we have for a different subject every year, which we work very closely with various United Nations organizations to present.
So World Future Council is one of the main partners of the ZEMAT Summit. Why did you accept to be a partner?
Because when I first heard about the ZEMAT Summit, I was very excited by the aims, and so I was very happy to, you know, be associated with this and see, you know, some of the speakers here. It is really an attempt, of course, coming out of the business sector and focused on the business sector, but, you know, going beyond that, seeing how can we work with civil society, with policymakers, how can we explore how to, you know, humanize globalization, the whole idea of the common good, a very difficult concept which has been debated for hundreds of years. But of course now we're in a very different situation. We're in a global emergency. I mean, there's no doubt about it. We are threatening through climate change and destroying the environment to make our planet uninhabitable within this century, within, you know, the lifetime of, you know, people alive already today. So that's why I felt, you know, when somebody makes an effort like this and starts an initiative like this, it is something I really would like to support.